Silberne Wochenlandmache. Für Carsten Brandt von Donnerwetter.de ist klar, das ist des Rätsels Lösung.
Wir wissen heute, dass es mit 99,9%iger Sicherheit Düppel waren. Düppel bestehen aus Plastik mit Plastikteilchen, so etwa mit Metalldampf drauf. Die dienen dazu, militärisch Radargeräte zu täuschen. Das ist deren Hauptaufgabe. Und da wurden wohl damals bei der ersten Geisterwolke mindestens hunderte Kilo, wenn nicht Tonnen, ausgesetzt, um so ein riesen künstliches Regenband zu erzeugen.
Nach den Radarbildern sind es Tonnen dieser Substanzen. Laut Bundeswehr wurden aber nur ganz geringe Mengen dieser Düppel ausgesetzt. Sie dienen der bewussten Täuschung von Radarbildern, da ihre Haarfarben im Feld. Es gibt längst Proteste gegen diese Technik. Und auch hierzulande regt sich was, zum Beispiel bei den Grünen in NRW.
Hier wird offensichtlich großflächig die Umwelt verschmutzt und das auch noch mit Geheimnistuerei verbunden. Und das muss auf den Tisch. Wir werden die Landesregierung danach fragen und die soll die Bevölkerung jetzt umfassend aufklären.
Und es geht schon wieder los. Derzeit gibt es neue Luftkampfübungen über dem Hunsrück. Die Bundeswehr warnte jetzt erstmals die Wetterdienste vor verfälschten Radarbildern in den kommenden 3 Wochen.
Die Prognose von uns sagt, dass wir Südwestwind haben. Das heißt, diese Wolke wird dann über die Eifel, ins Rheinland, ins Ruhrgebiet, weiter dann hier oben bis nach Ostwestfalen, Bielefeld, Paderborn, Osnabrück, dann sogar in Niedersachsen und bei entsprechend großer Menge sogar weiter nach Niedersachsen, vielleicht sogar bis in den Hamburger Raum hineingetragen. Also es ist ein richtiger Wolkenfilm, der dann entsteht bis nach Hamburg.
Carsten Brandt hatte nach der ersten Wolke bereits Strafanzeige gegen Unbekannt wegen Wettermanipulation gestellt. Er wird sein Radar in der nächsten Zeit genau beobachten, denn jede neue Geisterwolke könnte seine Vermutung bestätigen.
I think most people have noticed chemtrails because it's not natural to have something crisscrossing in your sky and staying around for hours. A chemtrail looks like a jet fume, but the jet discharge only lasts for about 15 or 16 seconds. And you can also see it keeps getting wider and wider, and if you look at it closely, it's dripping things. From a former worker at the Oak Ridge nuclear plant, I found that the approach of our government to chemtrails is twofold. One is they think if they put metals up there over places where there were cities or groups of people, they could deflect the sun's rays back up again, and so they could combat global warming. It's a kind of crazy, but anyway, that's one of the reasons. The other is what they're calling aerial pharmacopoeia. I think they're outrageous. They don't belong in our sky. And they're probably messing up things they don't even know about. We don't need this kind of dosing the population with unknown chemicals and messing up the body metabolism. I think they're also a carrier for all kinds of biological and chemical warfare. So I don't think they're dropping them on us right now, but they seem to be preparing. They're getting people used to seeing these things, and they're getting the military used to doing it. And they're probably practicing with things they consider relatively harmless, whether they really are. You know, we get fooled by a living system. things that we think are harmless are not. I find it very reckless to be putting things into the atmosphere without telling. It's certainly an approach to global warming. They ought to be joining the Kyoto Pact and reducing the harmful emissions, not adding more to the atmosphere. I saw them over Paris. When you come in from overseas and you're up above the clouds, they're all crisscrossed like a checkerboard over Paris. It's over Geneva. I've seen this myself. I'm sure it's over other countries. It's in England. It's in Belgium. So, you know, it's all over. They're doing this all over the earth. They totally deny it. They just say it's just the exhaust from a jet motor. They totally deny it.
Investigation and exclusive we first told you about a few months ago concerning some strange cloud in the skies over Southern California. Some say they are simply jet contrails, but others claim it's the government creating chemical clouds to combat global warming. Strange clouds over California. Some people, like those we met in Crestline, call them chemtrails, an alleged government program to combat global warming by creating clouds with chemicals. But former FDA analyst Rosalind Peterson says the evidence on the ground only raises more questions about what's in the air.
What makes you convinced it's showing up in the drinking water?
Every time they put a chemical in the air, then we're starting to see it in unusual spiking in California's drinking water supplies.
Peterson says she searched through public documents like these from NASA and the Air Force and found a long history of testing in the atmosphere with chemicals like barium and aluminum, said by the agencies to be used at safe levels. Those same chemicals, barium and aluminum and others, are showing up in water supplies across the state, spiking, sometimes above standards set by the Department of Health, and often around the same time as atmospheric test dates.
Now, the EPA tells us that high levels of aluminum and barium can affect the nervous system and cause high blood pressure. Again, we look forward to more analysis of that data from the Department of Health, and when we get it, we'll report back to you on their
mentioned high levels of barium linked to those alleged chemtrails. We wanted to find out exactly what effects barium has on the body. We spoke with Mark Ryan, the director of the Poison Control Center. Ryan tells KSLA News 12 that short-term exposure can lead to anything from stomach to chest pains. Long-term exposure causes blood pressure problems. Ryan addressed concerns by chemtrail researchers that barium could be meant to wear down a person's immune system.
Anything that causes ill effects in the body long term, chronically, is going to affect your ability because it's constantly working on the body. So from that aspect, yeah, it's a potential.
In recent years, peculiar cloud formations have been appearing in the skies all over the world with increasing frequency.
I think most of us in North America have wondered at these plumes crisscrossing the sky in grid patterns, parallel rows, and the now familiar X's. And many of us have wondered what these trails are.
While highly speculative, some researchers suggest these strange cloud formations are another agent of weather warfare. They first appear to be simply contrails, coming from high-flying jet airplanes. But these trails linger in the sky for many hours, some for even an entire day, forming an artificial cloud. Some researchers refer to them as chemtrails.
Chemtrails are deliberately sprayed by high-flying U.S. Air Force tankers, dispersing chemicals into the atmosphere.
Wilt Thomas has authored a book about chemtrails. Since the late 1990s, he has worked closely with another journalist in investigating these strange patterns that appear in the sky.
We have an FAA representative, in fact, a high government official, a person we came to call Deep Sky, attesting to the truth and the reality behind chemtrails. He described this program of spraying chemical trails at high altitudes in so-called commanded airspace, where commercial flights are routed around and beneath tanker airplanes belonging to the U.S. Air Force.
The theory is that chemtrails are being used in conjunction with HAARP. By spraying metal oxides into the air above enemy skies, then directing ELF waves from HAARP to heat those metal oxides, the temperature of the sky is raised to more than 100 degrees Fahrenheit, preventing the accumulation of water vapor that would otherwise form clouds and produce rainfall. The ELF waves HAARP produces bounce off the ionosphere and are able to curve around the Earth over the horizon to the ground, making any point on the globe well within reach.
One of the dangers in spreading chemtrails is that it acts as a desiccant and further dries the air. In other words, these chemical particulates can dry up the atmosphere and induce drought.
Chief of the Space Patrol and his cadet Happy are on their way back to Terra, capital of the United Planets.
Your host is Autolite, world's largest independent manufacturer of automotive electrical equipment. Autolite makes over 400 products for cars, trucks, tractors, airplanes, and boats in 28 plants from coast to coast. Autolite products include a complete line of ignition-engineered, standard, and resistor-type spark plugs, spark plug wire, distributor caps, generators, voltage regulators, and dependable stay-full batteries. Autolite products also include ornamental plastics, electric windshield wipers, wire and cable, fuel pumps, bullseye seal beam headlights, horns, and a complete line of original service parts for Autolite-equipped cars. Autolite serves the greatest names in the industry. So, from bumper to tail light, you're always right with Autolite.
In the workshop, camping, on the road, anywhere, without water. What a convenience. That's new Baraxo waterless hand cleaner. And remember Baraxo powdered hand soap in the attractive new plastic container.
We had a bunch of women, children, elderly people. They were all good people. They had different beliefs from others, different beliefs than I have, maybe different beliefs than you have in their way of life, and especially in their religious beliefs. But basically, they were good people. I was around them quite a lot. They were always nice, mannerly. They minded their own business. They were never overbearing. They were always clean and courteous. I liked them.
The Branch Davidians are a breakoff from the Seventh-day Adventist Church, Advent meaning the second coming of Jesus. The Davidians, starting with a man by the name of Victor Hotep in the 1930s and 40s, believe that God had once again visited his people with a living prophet. That's the key.
Victor Hotep claimed to be that living prophet and moved his followers to Waco, Texas from Southern California during the 1930s. Living outside town in cottages, the Davidians studied the Bible as literal truth. The Book of Revelation and its cryptic seven seals was their focus. Christians generally believe the seals tell God's planned sequence of events leading to Judgment Day, and that their true meaning can only be explained by the Lamb of God, a Messiah who will come during the last days. 5 years after Hoddis' death in 1954, all Davidians gathered at Mount Carmel. They believed Armageddon, the Bible's predicted final battle between good and evil, was close. Howell believed God chose him to be a contemporary Cyrus and free God's chosen people, just as the ancient Persian king Cyrus had defeated the Babylonians and freed the captive Jews. On returning to the United States, he legally changed his first name to David, honoring the Hebrew king David, and his last name to Koresh, after the Messiah Koresh mentioned in the book of Isaiah. Koresh is the Hebrew word for Cyrus.
What he essentially claimed was not to be God or not to be Jesus. And throughout the Hebrew scriptures, but particularly the book of Isaiah and many of the Psalms, in very detailed ways, and he would go through this.
Oh, this time, when Christ reveals himself, is going to be according to the book. Because there's some statements in there that might make you a little bit happy. Okay? Such as the rest of Psalms 40. Lord, I have preached righteousness in the great congregation. What's he going to preach?
Seven seals.
In fact,
increased the Davidians' numbers. In 1991, they recycled the lumber from the cottages and built the communal church that became familiar. Attracted by Koresh's biblical teachings, new members increased the Davidians' numbers. In 1991, they recycled the lumber from the cottages. Built the communal church that became familiar during the siege. As a multiracial congregation of all ages from around the world, residents contributed both their labor and money earned by work around Waco to support the spiritual life of Mount Carmel.
Whether we have a gun or not at this place. Guns are the right of Americans to have. Our government's the greatest in the world. We have freedom, not freedom for religion, not freedom for state, but freedom for all, you see? And that's what a lot of people don't understand.
What he usually quoted is a scripture from Jesus on the night of his arrest, where Jesus did not resist. Jesus says, From now on, let him who has no sword buy one.
Did King David have swords? Did Jesus tell the apostles to carry a sword with you? Yes.
In other words, say, get ready for the future.
This is for the little children, right? God knows how it should be. Stars and stripes are flying, give us justice and liberty for the children's sake. You know, you might have to bear a gun one day.
Now,
why do the heathen rage?